Well, hi guys. It is Tuesday morning, August the 9th. Trailer's as ready as it's going to be. Battery is strapped down for the emergency brake goodies. Two spares. Jack four-way in the back of the truck toolbox. Gas can, PB blaster, Efer, chains, binders at the wazoo, and just waiting on Jacob to get here. And we're on the road to an undisclosed location to pick up some undisclosed, unknown things. I ain't got to let the cat out of the bag just yet. So, we're playing things by ear. It's going to be a long ride. I guess the craziness runs rampant. Well, I see a few rocks. I better get off the trailer before we have a problem with that. You know how that goes. So, we'll be back here in a bit, guys. Loaded for bear just a little bit. So, we'll see you here in a bit.
We're on a wild adventure.
Just two wild and crazy guys on the road again.
In a wild intersection.
Yep. Weather.
Something. It runs that line against us.
Yep. We'll be back, guys.
moment. Yeah, let's see how the skyscraper is. There it is, in all its glory.
Yeah! Oh, look, Toledo! Well, you know, that one didn't have many brains.
They gotta dredge it so the propellers on the boats don't get wrapped with some sort of grass that grows underwater. Oh. Come on, I gotta break, you gotta break.
Yeah, we were westbound and down now.
For a while until the road turns back north.
Well, technically north, northwest.
Indiana state line.
Right here. Oh, we done crossed the border, son.
specified location.
Okay, we're in the Hoosier State. Let's see if we're going to a basketball game or an IndyCar race.
This is going to be fun.
It's under the loader.
Oh, it's ready and waiting. Well, I guess that gives it away.
Yeah.
Bandit's dragging that home, or I guess I'm dragging it home for Bandit.
Pull on up.
You mean you didn't want that big disc ripper back there?
No.
No.
No, that's pretty much useless for me. Oh.
I guess I should pull up a wee bit more.
Hey! Ha 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 ha! I don't know which way is high and low. Has it got a sticker?
Wait a minute. Ah, there we go. I know the way down.
Is there a sticker on there anywhere?
No, but what do you
know? Well, it should be in low range right now if it's back. Theoretically.
I'm just going to drive it around and try it.
Okay. Snap it forward. Pull it back. Slowed down, didn't it?
What?
Slowed down, didn't it?
I don't know. Maybe it's just first gear.
Just don't run over your camera.
I will say that 901 has easier power steering. Does this have oil in it? Did we check that?
Nope. Armstrong for now.
Yeah. What sucks is I can only use one brake. There's no way to lock these brakes together, is there?
Yeah.
You can attack the rail spacing too.
Just be gentle. Little more. Shut her off and put her in gear.
I might need to go check my undershorts. We got it.
I gotta tell you, I'm impressed.
I gotta tell you, I'm impressed I didn't shit myself. Because that brake, I've only got one brake and I can't do like clutch and.
That's done it many times.
I mean, it's not.
That front end gets a little light on him, son of a bitch.
It wasn't bad, it's the fact that I was trying to like stop and steer with the wrong brake. I'm like, why am I not going left?
Now the heart
loaded a unit system, which you're sitting way off to the side on a semi.
Yeah,
without brakes.
Oh, without brakes.
On a semi, like on a low flatbed semi, off using ramps. So you, because it's so one-sided heavy, you feel like you're leaning. Oh, as it is. And I didn't have brakes, so I'm sitting there like feathering the clutch, like I gotta make this in one try. The variable speed is all the way slow. First gear. I feel like I'm gonna fall off the side of the trailer.
Jacob, yeah. I give you a big kudos and thumbs up.
Hell yeah. We're stopping for ice cream.
Alright. You did put it in gear.
Yes, it's in first.
Okay.
Because I know how to find first.
Okay.
Yes, the glorious double H pattern.
Now you can gently back up.
About a toolbox or something. Went up.
Yep. Now you can gently back up, and we'll hook the trailer back up. and start chaining down.
I'd have to go clean my pants out.
Well, I know I was going to roll over. It was just whether I was going to have the front end fall off the side of the ramp because I'm sitting there hitting the brake wanting to turn and it's going.
Oh, man. Oh, these young pups, they got a lot to learn. Oh, shit. I've been doing this since...
Long time.
60s.
First tractor I ever drove was in the 60s. It was an Oliver 60 with a mechanical brake. Well, road cultivated that son of a gun.
I started with a 60 with a two-row, fully mounted hand crank.
It worked beautifully. With it right there, you can sit there and watch that.
Trying to use the wrong one. I was hitting the right, wanting to steer it left, and was sending the front off the side of the trailer.
We've never loaded one quite like that, so we never really needed it.
Next time, man, you gotta look at the whole sail list there.
Right? Yeah. Well,
I wonder how much I'm drawing. I paid $125 for the one I got. Slightly
different. Now, trying to figure out how this is going to be easy because it's going to go here, here.
You're going to go around or do both?
I don't know if I want to go around.
It's really here. Short. It's so short.
And then back up under and then go.
The problem is, do you have enough room for a binder? Or do you put a binder in the middle?
We'll put a binder in the middle.
And hook it straight. Or, this hole. Individually, like individual sales.
No, they have. This one's a little different than mine. It's a little smaller there. That was a hard thing. It's smaller.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. You just gotta go through the pages to find it. And it was like 10 pages of stuff.
For this thing.
Okay.
Sign my two together for my ear corn.
Well, we're loaded up and headed south. I'd get over as quick as possible.
Yes.
Yeah, those are a little wet.
Yeah, just trying not to clip their trailer.
Yep.
I like how they're pulled this way out in the middle of nowhere on the property.
Yeah.
It's not close to the house, not close to nothing.
Well, I was right.
What?
It was real close.
Yeah.
Easy to get to.
Bandits rolling. We're all shooting video.
Yeah, we're going crazy.
Yes. And if we look behind us, or just in the mirror,
yes,
we've got a tractor and a cornet, and the wide open road right in front of us. So before I get out on the road, we're going to shut this down and drive, and I'll catch you guys when we get somewhere with something.
Yeah. Food! Oh, shut up, camera.
No, that's turn, I'm turning it off.
Well, guys, here we go again. We'll be back. Oh, wow. This is our exit.
Yeah.
Woohoo!
So soon.
Jacob, are we there yet?
We're heading back already.
Yeah, but are we there yet?
We were already there.
Are we home?
I wish.
How long do we get home?
About 4 hours. And it'll be even slower.
Right turn, Clyde! Decatur. Have an interesting ride home, aren't we?
I don't know, it's up to you.
You're driving, not me.
As long as y'all brought our refill of Happy Pills, we'll be fine.
Yeah.
I'm out of Tic Tacs.
We'll have to stop. Must have Jacob Happy Pills. Those are very, very important.
Yes, Tic Tacs, fresh minty bread.
We'll be back in a bit, guys.
Found the Amish around Marin.
Lots of the Amish in this part of the country.
south?
Yep, headed towards Fern. Oh, that's a one way to mow the lawn. Ooh. He was leaning into it hard.
Out mowing hay.
Guess they're done with the rain up here or something. Ray figures if it's raining, it can't rain tomorrow, and it's going to be clear afterwards. I know they're not looking on the Weather Channel app.
No. They're not Amish.
Yeah, power lines.
Yep. That's Amish. This is Amish. If you don't see the power lines...
Oh, we missed the options, eh? And a lot more stuff.
Oh. Somebody's a choochin. Somebody out on the road on roller skates?
Yes. Well, probably roller blades. Jebediah's gotta get home.
Now I have seen it all.
That's a new one for me. That's a something.
I've never seen an Amish on roller blades.
Always a bike. Well, it's flat through here, so it's not getting brakes on a bike.
I'm flabbergasted. That's something I never thought I would see.
We're learning all sorts of new stuff today.
Yeah. It's a good thing we drove this way.
Moo Juice Express. That's a great name. I like that for a milk dollar. Yep, here it is. Welcome to Fern.
Fern, Indiana. Indiana Dutch.
They speak Pennsylvania Dutch, bro.
Ah, okay.
Because it said it will come in, like, German on the sign.
Nice vacancy. Okay, guys. We'll be back. We can breathe again. Are we there yet?
It'll make me dump you in that municipal waste puddle of a wetland mess back there. I wish we had smell-o-vision because something was not right. You got a water treatment plant on one side of the road. Across the street, there's an NRCS sign that says, Restoring America's Wetlands, an NRCS project. And I would much rather live in a hog barn. The stink was so bad.
It was pretty bad.
And then the creek, less than a mile down the road, was full of algae.
Oh, look what's in front of us!
Buggy! Black punch buggy!
Oh no, we're not going to... No, don't... You can't say that.
Well, I mean, it's... They have a very... They have a black umbrella.
Whoa.
Black paint on the wheels.
Yeah. It's like a dude. This is a stop sign.
Ah, Brian, I think it's where the combine parts are.
Possibility.
I'd like to see around the curve better before I pass.
Car coming.
Yeah. We'll just take it nice and slow skis. Well, or not. I really don't want to ask you guys, but thank you.
There you go, Jacob. That's what you need.
Well, it might work for all our mud.
No, scratch that. That's got them little narrow skinny tracks. Well,
I mean, really, I don't see why the Amish wouldn't try to use one that doesn't have air in the tires. Might be a wee bit new.
Well, I don't know. Where are we, anyway?
This little hole in the wall is called Bryant. And somewhere around here is a combine junkyard. Pretty sure. I think it's Bryant, Indiana.
I don't know. Guys, we'll be back.
What is that? Is that just really sad beans on that one side? No, well, back there, we'll close to the house. I know half the beans.
Emerald.
But the other side, the rows look like they were 5 feet apart.
That's kind of sad looking. Ah, here's the road sign. It'll tell us where we're at.
Portland.
15 miles from Richmond. Alright, we'll be back. As they say, just hold your horses. What was that?
That was me. Squeaking for the brakes.
Now you know they're gonna look at us funny.
Yeah, we got a big load and all sorts of fun stuff back here. Well, let's not hit the tire remnants.
Them damned English taking our stuff.
What? Old gas tractors? Hayless ponies?
Yeah. Well, that's two horses and buggies for the day.
It took us long enough. I figured we would have hit a bunch around Vernon if we didn't.
Well, it's nasty and rainy. What do you expect? Now, if it had been dry and sunny, yeah, we probably would have.
Like Motel 6, I leave the light on for you.
Okay, guys, we've come about 60 mile, and it's time to check. Jacob, shake that. Shake that thing.
Well, my city girl get the nightclub?
That ain't going nowhere.
I guess not.
We better...
We're in Portland, Indiana, but they have a big show. Well, that's one way to make it tighter. But now you're making the other side look a little sloppy.
We'll get there. That's why we're checking.
Which we didn't show off the chain job on the corn head.
Chain job on the corn heads. All right, it's tight.
Sweet on that side. I wonder if I'd have just thought Amanda had a great idea. Through like the feet on the row units.
She's a tight. Got the little flappity flappities in the wind. She's a good and tight.
I don't think we've lost anything. My screen's still holding the battery flap down. The flapper. Look at where the flapper goes.
It
looks kind of like the 1086. This is a really fast tractor. Very fast tractor.
Yeah, it goes so fast it bent the muffler back.
The muffler might have been leaning when we got it.
Yeah, that's true.
Yes. Don't blame me. Say it was like that when we got it. Just means it's a speedy tractor, right?
Yeah. That's what you call a Kentucky Go Faster.
Didn't have to plug it for a turbo.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna go get some Biddles. So we'll be back, guys.
And they about dumped like the front portion into the creek next to the road. When they were like trying to get it off. Oh, brakes on the truck and jam it underneath it. And then you lock a couple pins, drove away so it would fall down, you lock the bottom pins, and then you shove the truck back underneath and lift the air and then lift the air system. Wonder what he's hauling.
Bridge girder, it looks like. Or a piece of one.
Oh, yay.
Oh, lovely.
I mean, now that ground might not have been far. I'll give it that much. It's like an industrial park.
Yeah.
So, there probably would be running cattle on it.
Oh, shitload of them over there, too. Yeah.
Cut the tassels off. past us on the horn. Shoot, we gotta go past the lights, make a left hand turn, come back.
Yeah. They got the same thing over at the Navy on 32.
Yeah, I haven't experienced that in rush hour, but it sounds...
It's goofy. Yeah.
Sounds like you're wiping your butt without toilet paper.
Kind of.
Saves the trees, but not your name.
Germaine!
We survived.
Another one of them dumbass things.
Yeah, you gotta make a U-turn to be able to make a left.
Yep.
The traffic's backed up so far, you're not gonna make that U-turn. Somehow they thought that was better than they had in the third lane.
Yep. Oh, look, they're growing trees out there.